Today we will provide an overview of BWIQ, our chemometric software, which allows for extensive data analysis and modeling of spectroscopic data. In this video, we will go over the layout and major functions of the BWIQ software. Detailed, stepwise explanations for developing quantitative PLS regression models, as well as classification models, are presented in our previous BWIQ support videos. BWIQ software supports numerous file formats, so you can readily import your instrument data for analysis. It uses a logical workflow, so users can work from left to right through the steps of analysis. We start by creating a training file, and then when all the data are imported and the analysis steps defined, we will execute the method to create a model file, which can then be used for on and offline predictions. First, we will import our data. Go to File, Import, and choose the format. The imported data are displayed in a table and plotted. There are also quadrants on the left of the files for the algorithms and algorithm properties that will be used. In order to develop a model for the sample data, we will need to enter more information about them. This includes adding the response variable y and also defining how samples can be used in the model as either calibration spectra, validation spectra, or NORD spectra that will be excluded from the model. Select the blue plus sign in the top left corner of the spectral list to add columns for y, and then fill in the added column by typing in or copying and pasting values from a table or spreadsheet. These numerical values can correspond to a specific class for a classification model, or can also be related to concentrations that are used to develop a quantitative regression model. BWIQ software is designed with a logical workflow. We move from left to right across the menu for the sequential steps in our analysis. Moving across the top menu, we can begin by checking the data for spectral outliers, which can then be ignored from any further analysis steps. After this step, we can continue on to partition the data for their use as calibration or validation spectra. There are three automatic options for this, or a user can assign samples manually. We can now save this file as a training file with the extension .train, and then continue on to spectral preprocessing. Preprocessing steps are applied to data to accentuate the signal in spectra related to chemical changes, and to minimize and remove non-chemical effects, such as background and baseline shifts. Let's take a look at the pre-processing options and how they can be applied. When any pre-processing step is selected, it is added to the algorithms list, and the properties can be adjusted from the default settings in the algorithm properties quadrant. Once set, click the blue plus symbol to add it to the algorithms list in the upper left. It is possible to apply more than one pre-processing step, but be careful not to overprocess your data. Now that we have our pre-processing steps, in order to remove spectral regions we are not interested in, we can then define the spectral region for analysis using a manual variable selection. Our next step is to define the type of modeling we will use for this data, either regression or classification. If there are no Y values associated with the data, the only option available is PCA analysis. In BWIQ, there are several regression options available. PLS is the most common. When there is only one Y variable, PLS1 is available. When there is more than one Y value in the data, PLS2 is an option. You can set the properties for the PLS algorithm before adding it to the algorithms list. If we have class data, we can choose one of the four classification algorithms available in BWIQ. These classification algorithms require at least three samples for each class and can model up to six different classes. There is also a calibration transfer function in the software that can be used to transfer a calibration made in one portable instrument to be used with another. We can now save this as a training file, the extension .train, which can be executed by clicking the blue play arrow to create the model file with the extension .cmml. As long as the model is saved as a training file, it can be edited or modified. Let's open a model file. We see that the menu for the model file is different than the menu for the training file, instead having tools that can be used to evaluate the model and to predict new samples. This regression model can be evaluated using the menu bar icons, including the predicted versus measured plot, scores, loadings, and residuals. To predict new samples using the model, we go to Predict and select the data. The samples are predicted and results displayed. These can be summarized in a PDF report, which shows all the results and all model details. For more information on using the BWIQ software, please refer to the user manual, which includes tutorials, and to our other support videos. You can also reach us at www.bwtek.com/support. Thank you for watching.